make your love too. But I'm gonna talk as I love to. Be free and be safe. They can talk all they want to. They can tell you what they can love to.
Rock down the river. Yo, 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 yo.
Empire Selassie.
When it comes to Rastafari and politics, it's always been far removed from each other. It's like oil and water, it doesn't mix. But having said that, there has to be a connection somewhere. And as much as Marley would try to run away from the fact that he's an entertainer, he's a Rastafarian, and he's not into politics, a lot of his music's had so much political undertones. I mean, Rat Race had its undertones. Crazy Ballhead, when he talks about chasing the crazy ballheads out of town, I mean, it's all about politicians, building penitentiaries, building schools, brainwash education to make us the fools, hatred and reward for love, telling us about your God above. It's religion, it's about establishment controlling people at the end of the day. So this is one of the reasons why Rastafari, and especially he tried to make a point in trying to disassociate himself with politics. And as you know, shortly, in December of 1976, he went on to be shot himself because of political reasons. And standing within a few years after that, he went on to have a performance of the most memorable performance in Jamaica's history, bringing the two politicians, Michael Manley and Edward Sitwalker, together during a period of time where there's so much rife and killing throughout certain parts of Jamaica because of the negative political climate at that time. So there he was running away from politics, but got caught between and raising the hands of the two politicians. And one of the things he says, what are we killing ourselves for over these two guys? You know, that those were not his literal words, but that's the way I interpret it. And it was just his way of saying, well, look, this is what politics is about. So, you know, at the end of the day, you don't have to be a politician to say the word politics, in a sense, but at the same time, the world for me is political. The birth of every man on this earth, especially the birth of an African, is a political move in itself. And I think in so many ways, Bob Marley probably recognized that. But with the way Rastafari was growing at the time, I don't think it would have been so easy for one to say that there and then, mm-hmm. when it comes to political attributes. Because there's times, you know, that it's a new philosophy in itself, a new culture in itself, and over the years, I think Rasta has seen where politics has to get involved in what it's about. I mean, I might get knocked, my comments might get knocked senselessly for being said, but that's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it because, like I said, when it comes to censorship, when it comes to counter the odds when it comes to finance and everything else, and who's generating finance, who's generating, and when it comes to economical purposes, it's very hard to disassociate ourselves, especially if we want to get ahead in life as Rastafarians and make sure that everybody eats. There's no way you can do it without understanding what politics is about. You don't have to be a politician, but I think it's necessary for you to understand the politics, because the politics in so many ways is the reasons why there is suppression. So you got to understand what is suppressing you, what is repressing you, what is oppressing you, things like that, and ultimately depressing you because of all these negativities. You got to understand what they're about for you to overcome them, obviously with the power of the Most High, Jah Rastafari. While I'm on the subject as well, it's 45 years this year since Haile Selassie actually went on Jamaican soil for the first time, you know, in flesh. And the rest is history. Rastafari.
Rousing, boisterous, tumultuous welcome ever given to any visiting or local celebrity, His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie I, Emperor of Ethiopia, arrived. The crowd erupted into a frenzy of rejoicing as they broke through the lines of soldiers and police and surged out onto the tarmac, eager to engulf the Emperor with their affection. Ceremonial welcome that was planned had to be abandoned as the avalanche of men, women, and children swept away all semblance of order.
But reggae, and especially the music of Bob Marley's, and I say this because after Bob Marley's passing, there was a big void within the industry. The void simply because the industry recognized him, and because everybody else's music was so far removed and a lot different than what he was doing, as well as other political industry red tape issues, the music was short-lived after Bob Marley's untimely demise. So during that period of time, dancehall music kicked in with acts like Yellow Man, Shabaranks as we know it, just to name a few. But then it's never really had itself established and had the impact as it did while Marley was around. Having said that, as far as carrying the mantle is concerned, there's been so much speculation as to who, what, where, and when. And when it comes to the mantle, I mean, we were recognized simply because it was while Bob Marley was lying in hospital that we arrived on U.S. soil for the first time. And then when his sons got mature enough, people expected Ziggy, Stevie, you know, any one of the brothers to be part of carrying the mantle.
Crime and violence, trials and tribulations. Well, the unemployment of real up youngster boy here. And them for no. Boys, the one riot alongside Gang Molly, I wish some guy feel like. Set up! Come!
Hey! Is this violence in the street? My God, just got no time to sleep. Let them can't find a job. Cause they've got no credentials.
It's a tough one because we're in the dancehall period right now. And as we know, Bob Marley is a reggae artist, and today we're dealing with a lot of dancehall, as we know it. Although they are the other side to the whole experience where there is still reggae, but what industry tends to be catering for a lot more is dancehall. Having said that, I think if Bob was around, he would have been dabbling in dancehall himself, but in his own particular kind of way. I think he still would have had the roots element in it, as opposed to what dancehall is known for today in many ways. Things about women and guns and a lot of money and things like that. I think Bob would still have been focusing on the political issues and the issues of the sufferer at home and abroad, far and wide, way across Africa. Because I think in his heart, and in our hearts, we believe that's what he came to do. So as far as carrying the mantle, there's so much people, and I can only say this, that when it comes to Bob Marley and people carrying the mantle today, I can only compare it with what I saw when I saw Spike Lee's movie, Malcolm X, where at the very end of the movie, it was Malcolm X at the beginning, and as you know, he got assassinated. And at the very end of the movie, if you can remember, all the children were standing up one by one saying, I am Malcolm X, I am Malcolm X, I am Malcolm X. Well, I see the Bob Marley experience in almost exactly the same way, where I don't think there's going to be one particular person anymore as such. I think everybody is going to have to play a part in bringing that message across of liberation, righteousness, truthfulness, and you know, the fear of God in this time, and universal harmony.